Is it time to make the subways and buses free? Los Angeles County is moving down that path, slowly. The idea's been kicking around for several years, but a pilot program just got underway, for K-12 students only, and only at participating schools and school districts, in recent weeks. Next up, more K-12 schools and then perhaps community college students as well. After that, the program will, proponents hope, be expanded to provide free service to low-income riders. And if all goes well during what could be a two-year experiment, the ultimate goal is to eliminate fares on Metro's buses and subways altogether. LA would be the first big city in the country to take such a radical step. The Fareless System Initiative is an appealing idea. Los Angeles absolutely needs to get people out of their cars and onto the buses and subways, reducing traffic, air pollution and carbon emissions. Economics 101 tells us that doing away with fares would encourage that by making driving relatively more expensive as transit becomes cheaper. Furthermore, subways and buses are ridden mostly by low-income Angelenos, disproportionately people of color, many of them carless and transit-dependent. The median household income of El Metro riders is $19,325. For many, the cost of transportation is not insignificant as they travel to jobs, schools and medical appointments each day. Besides, and this is more of a philosophical issue, mass transit is a public good that a lot of people feel should be funded by and available to all. Just as we provide our sidewalks and roads to be used without direct costs, it's time to consider looking at transit the same way, said Mayor Eric Garcetti at the Metro Board of Directors meeting in May. But before we jump, there are important questions that need to be answered. Will eliminating fares really boost ridership? How much revenue will be lost and how will it be made up? Will free transit lead to service cutbacks or reduced reliability or, God forbid, higher taxes? Before the pandemic, in 2019, Metro counted 1.2 million daily weekday passenger boardings on average. But ridership had been declining. It fell 17.8% from 2014 to 2018, according to UCLA's Institute of Transportation Studies. Currently, subway or bus fare is $1.75 per ride, or $100 for a monthly pass. It adds up to about $250 million to $300 million annually, or it did before COVID. That's a lot of money to give up voluntarily, but it's actually only a fraction, 13% in 2019, of the full cost of providing bus and subway service. It's not clear exactly how the foregone millions would be made up if fares were eliminated. Metro officials said early on they wouldn't seek further sales tax increases. They argued that state and federal grants, reduced costs related to fare collection and enforcement, new advertising sales and other initiatives would cover the difference.